So, kind of had to resituate the camera because it kind of did a weird thing, but let's continue. Hi everyone, welcome back to All About the Melody. This video is an artist that I really like and I'm really excited to listen to it. I kind of already cheated and listened to it the day it came out. Sorry, but I had to. This is Tate McRae-Slower. If you like this video, make sure to comment, subscribe, and do all that jazz. It would mean the world to me, and thank you guys so much for those of you who have. Let's get into it. Can't be someone I don't recognize. Like, you can't be someone you're not, and if you are, it's kind of weird. I can say this from experience because I mentioned this before, but it's just not fun to be someone you're not. Tate's voice is very pretty, and the way she, I guess, expresses her words with emotion is, like, on top of it. It's so good. The type to have to say it twice, wait for you till the end of the night. I'll be following advice and you don't seem to move, but is it worse for me? Okay, so let's finish that line first, but I've got something to say. If I tell the truth. Okay, I've been falling fast and you don't seem to move, but is it worse for me if I tell the truth? Like, okay, I like this. It's basically saying, like, I like this person and they don't seem to like me back, but is it going to end well if I tell the truth and say it? I feel like that's a thought going through every teenager's mind, is we're worried about rejection and what ifs. But I wouldn't know, I'd know my side of the story. Yeah. Are you just a poison that I should use? Wish I could say to you what I could say to you. Take it slower, wait until we're older, but I might be somebody you might not even know. I'm going to we could wait till we're older, but I might be somebody and you might not even know her. People change, and people change every day. They might be small changes, but they're still changes, and over time those changes add up to where maybe some of you is the same, but after time you become a different person. And in this song, I think she's asking, I don't know if you like the person I would be in the future. I don't even know if you like me now. So, again, thoughts that go through a teenager's mind. I feel like with that line, especially with me, it's like, I want to finish high school, I want to go to college, but at the same time, like, I don't want to grow up, I want to stay a kid. So it's finding the balance of being, of maturing and still being a kid. And I feel like that's something teenagers now need to learn, teenagers at any time need to learn, because they're like, oh, I want to grow up and be able to do whatever I want. But they don't understand the price that comes with that. And I do because, well, my parents didn't wait until they were older at all. And I just don't want to go through that myself. So I'm, like, trying to find the balance of taking life slow, but at the same time, like, not procrastinating things. And I'm not sure if I'm doing a good job, but I'm going to keep trying. We might end up strangers somehow, you should get to know me today. It's like I said, eventually you become completely different people than you are now. And, okay, I'll give you an example. So I went to in public school for the past couple days, and it was so weird seeing some of my friends that I haven't seen in forever because, you know, with the whole shutdown thing, we couldn't go to school and everything. And it was like we were almost two completely different people. Like, we were still ourselves, but we had different, we were matured in different ways, and it was kind of weird because we weren't the same middle schoolers we were last year. And, like, we're still friends and everything, but it's just a little awkward sometimes because you don't know exactly what to say for some cases. So you should get to know me today. It's like, you should get to know me for who I am right now. Because one day, that's not going to be the case, and I'm not going to be the same person. The video kind of reminded me of You Broke Me First. You know how when she, like, was doing the video, and they would write it out? That kind of is what it reminds me of. My friends and you don't seem to move, but is it worse for me if I tell the truth? And are you just a poison that I shouldn't use? Wish I could say to you what I could say to you. We could take it slower. I like how the background, like, isn't intense, and her tone is different from her other songs a little bit. I like when artists switch it up because some artists just, like, naturally have the same tone, and they do somewhat the similar things. They do similar things with it as in their last videos, but I like when artists switch it up because it keeps you interested, because they don't sound like a repeated record, you know? Not trying to, like, diss anyone or anything, that's my opinion. Okay, that line, I know I've commented on it before, but I'm going to comment on it again. When she says, wish I could say to you what I can't say to you, like, I am terrible with words. As you guys probably noticed, I'm, like, messing up so many times. So, I can't, it takes me a while to get to know, like, what I want to say and to be able to get the courage to say it. So, when I actually have something, like, important to say, I'm going to try to say it in the best way I can, but sometimes that meaning can, like, default or deflate, I guess. I don't know. So that's why I stick to writing, because writing, I don't have to say it. I write it, you know, and I can write better than I can speak. And I feel like that's what songwriting is for, is to tell a story when you can't use the words. I've been told that behind every girl's favorite song is an untold story, and sometimes in songs, the words they use, the media can, like, cover up what they're really trying to say because, you know, there's rumors and there's all this different stuff, and to me, writing is what I feel, and it's what I'm going through right now, and it's something that I want to talk about, but I don't know how to say it, so I write it out in hopes of, like, when I feel ready to talk about it, I'll show you what I mean. You know? I don't know if that made sense, but I hope it did. Okay, Changes and Roller Coaster, when she says those two words, I think of Justin Bieber because the Changes album and the song Roller Coaster when he was going through that really rough period. But that's a weird fact, and I just thought I'd throw it out there because, you know, That's just who I am.
We could take it slower.
So, kind of had to re-situate the camera because it kind of did a weird thing. But riding on the elevator reminds me of, and I don't know if I've said this because the computer did, or camera, not computer. The camera did something weird, but the riding on the elevator seems like the riding she did for You Broke Me First. And I really like it. This was Tate McRae Slower. Thank you guys so much for watching, and see you next video. Bye, everyone!